After you have unpacked and assembled your stencil cutter, you are ready to get the cutter set up correctly and load the stencil material. The 536 GTS is equipped with a dual drive tracking system that utilizes both friction feed pinch wheels and sprocket guide wheels to provide accurate cutting and tracking over distance. The sprockets are adjustable and can accommodate punched stencil material in widths from 15 inches to 30 inches. The stencil material you purchase should be punched using the half-inch on-center punch pattern. The use of unpunched material is not recommended. The cutter stand kit comes with one metal collar installed on one of the media roller bars that mount to the back of the cutter stand. Loosen the set screw with the Allen wrench provided. Using a straight edge, align the inside of the collar with the outside of the sprocket wheel closest to the main control panel. Tighten the set screw to hold the collar in place. To load the stencil material, place the roll onto the guide bars with the material coming from the back of the roll and the backing side down. Raise the rear lift gates. These gates are spring-loaded and will remain up when raised to the full up position. Raise the pinch rollers by lifting the lever on the left side of the machine. Roll off enough material to pass through the machine. Feed the material from the back of the cutter with the backing side down over the sprocket bar. Align material onto rear sprocket wheels first, making sure that your material is not skewed in any way. Lower the rear lift gate, making sure that the grooves in the retaining collars are aligned over the sprockets. Loosen the clutch knob located at the left side of the machine by turning counterclockwise. At this point, the front sprockets should be free to rotate by hand to facilitate alignment of the sprockets to the material holes. When you have aligned the sprockets to the material, lower the front lift gate, again checking to be sure the grooves in the retaining collars are aligned over the sprockets. The pinch wheels are movable. To move the pinch rollers, raise the lever, then grasp the roller assembly in the front and back and slide it into position. The right and left pinch wheels should be placed a minimum of 1/8 of an inch inside the sprocket holes. The center rollers should be positioned evenly across the stencil material. Never position the rollers over the smooth areas on the grit bar, marked with a red dot above them. Be sure that the pinch rollers are aligned and straight, then lower the lever. Do not adjust the sprocket wheels closest to the main control panel. They should remain at the factory setting. Next, the material will need to be tensioned. The cutter should be turned on and the pinch wheels should be in the up position during this procedure. Tensioning is accomplished by pulling downward with light pressure on the front edge of the material using your hand placed in the center of the material. You should feel slight resistance from the cutter. Tighten the clutch by turning it clockwise and lower your pinch wheels. You are ready for cutting. To move material back and forth through the cutter, toggle the Ready Load button to load and use the arrow keypads. Press the up arrow to move the material forward and the down arrow to move the material backward. Change the speed of movement with the joystick speed button. Always roll off enough media from the roll to complete your cut so that the cutter is not pulling material from the heavy roll. Advance material back and forth through the machine for 8 to 10 feet and watch for any binding, bunching, or other tracking issues. Continue to feed material back and forth through the machine, making adjustments as needed until you are able to get good tracking over the distance needed to complete your cut job. Thank you for your purchase of a 536 GTS Monument Stencil Cutter from ADSI. If you have questions or need assistance, please contact ADSI or your authorized ADSI reseller.